Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to make a song in GarageBand. So I'm using GarageBand 10 to create a simple song using loops. I'm going to do that by starting with an empty project. I'm going to choose that empty project and then I'm going to choose software instrument here from the left. I'm not actually going to use any software instruments in here, and it comes up with the software instrument panel. I'm just going to close that and close the left sidebar and then use the space to add some loops. So to add some loops, I'm going to click on the loop button right here. It's going to bring up the loop browser. And I can browse through all these different loops many different ways. Like for instance, I could select some of the tags here, like say piano and jazz together, and then even do something like clean. And then it'll give me the results here at the bottom of everything that fits that criteria. And I could reset it and decide I want to do guitars and I want to do grooving and intense. And I get some loops here as well. You can also just search here at the top for loops, or you can just deselect all the criteria and basically just go through each one of them. And to preview a loop, let's do a bass loop here. And let's do something urban. And to preview a loop, we just basically click it. To add one of these, we simply drag it into our song here. So our song is going to start off with one track that's classic electric piano. We'll select that, command delete deletes it, and now we have this one track here that we had just dragged in. And we're going to take this one loop here and we're going to loop it by dragging the right side, but it has to have this little loop cursor there. And once you do that, you can see it repeats the loop over and over again. You can see how many times it repeats it. It's pretty straightforward, and if you play it, it'll just repeat that loop. And these are all created in such a way so they loop very cleanly. So let's add another loop. This time we'll do drums here, and we'll select something rock. And notice here we've got two different types of loops. We have these green ones here, and they're musical notes that are played using an instrument. And you can edit those a little bit more or change the instrument. So for instance, we can select this one here and change the drum kit. These blue ones here, they're recorded audio. So it's just going to basically play back a recorded track, and you can't change a drum kit from that. Let's drag and drop this one in here. There we go. And then we'll loop it a bunch of times. Let's make these match. And now if we were to play this, we would be playing both of these tracks together. And we can adjust some things here. Like for instance, we can adjust the volume for each one of these pretty easily. All you need to do for that is just slide one of these back and forth. So we can bring the bass way down and play it. We can even do it live. So you can preview these sounds here while this is playing. So I can rewind this to the beginning, and I'm going to select a rock guitar part here. So let me play this, and then I will click on one of these to start listening to that over it. So you could see how I switch between them. This is a really quick way to find something that's going to mesh with what you've got. Let's say let's add this one here. And we don't have to add it at the very beginning here. We can add it two measures in and have it loop from there. So now we've got it where we'll start playing it and then the guitar will come in. So let's move the loops aside so we have more room to work here. And I could stretch these loops as long as I like, and I don't have to just have them in one set here. For instance, I can take this loop right here, make sure I'm in this track, copy it, and then move to another section here, and then paste it in, and then move this part around. So there's a lot you can do there. You can have this guitar come in and then come out, have a different guitar part come in here, and then of course add another track here where you can record your vocals or another instrument to add. So you can use loops by themselves to create a song, or you can use loops as kind of backing for a song that has other parts that you record. And there's all sorts of different things you can do. Just keep adding, and you can have as many of these tracks as you want. Bring in all sorts of different things into it to play. So play around and try different things. Experiment. Have fun. It's that's the whole point of using GarageBand, is have a lot of fun here and maybe create some of your own music. This is ideal for if you record presentations or videos and you don't want to use canned music. You can combine these loops in nearly infinite ways, so you can really create your own unique background music for your presentations. And when you're done, all you need to do is go to Share and then Export Song to Disk, or you can do it to iTunes. Either way, you could bring it into iMovie and Keynote and other apps for use there.